1 point C, uncertainty in measurements. This lesson is for Thursday, September 11th, and this assignment is due on Thursday, September 11th. The EQ is how do I use significant figures when performing calculations. The objective is students will be able to express answers to the proper number of significant figures in an operation. The real-world connections are as follows. All measurements, especially in the absence of scientific equipment, presents uncertainty and error. The outline of the lesson is as follows. First, we'll be going over percent error. B, we'll be going over significant figures. C, we'll be going over significant figures and operations. D, we'll be going over guided practice questions. And E, we'll be going over homework questions. First, let's go over percent error. Below here, this is shown on table T of the reference tables that you'll be receiving soon in class. But the percent error formula is shown on table T, and it's as follows. The percent error is equal to the measured value minus the accepted value divided by something called the accepted value. And once you get that quotient, or once you divide these two numbers that you get, the numerator divided by the denominator, you have to multiply it by 100 to get the actual percent error. Because otherwise, usually, the value here, or the quotient, will be a decimal. All right, measured value usually means what you actually get, whereas the accepted value is usually what you find in a book, or basically what you're looking for. It's the ideal. So think of accepted value as the ideal, or what you find in a book, and measured value is what you actually find in, like, a lab. All right, so again, it's measured minus accepted divided by accepted, and once you get that, you have to multiply it by 100 to get the percent error, and this is shown in table T. All right, so let's try an example here just to get a better sense of this. All right, example one says the measured value of the concentration of a solution is found to be 5.93 moles per liter. The accepted value is 6.93 moles per liter. Calculate the percent error of this measured value. So if we look at the measured value, it says it's 5.93 moles per liter. All right, and the accepted value, in this case, it says, is 6.93 moles per liter. So all we need to do is plug in the measured and the accepted values, and then we can solve for the percent error. So percent error equals measured minus accepted divided by accepted times 100%. So the measured value, 5.93, minus the accepted value, 6.93, divided by 6.93, which is the accepted value, times 100% will give you the percent error. So again, we do measured, 5.93, minus the accepted, 6.93, divided by the accepted, 6.93, and we multiply that by 100. So if we do 5.93 minus 6.93, we get a difference of negative 1.00 moles per liter. All right, so that's our difference between measured and accepted. All right, and we divide that by the accepted value of 6.93 moles per liter, as shown in the problem. Once we divide these two, we're going to have to multiply by 100. All right, so let me just show you what you get in a calculator. You got to do, first of all, 5.93 minus 6.93. Okay, you get negative 1, or negative 1.00. You divide that by 6.93, you'll get this as a decimal, as I said before. All right, then you have to multiply that by 100 to get the percent error. You get negative 14.43%. All right, however, what I want you to note is percent error, no matter what, is always going to be positive. All right, so even though you get negative 14.43%, initially, you just have to make it positive, because percent error is always positive. Basically, the reason why percent error is always positive is because you can't say something like, my measurement is negative 10% off of the accepted value. You would say, my percent error is about 10%, or my measurement is about 10% off the actual or accepted value. You can't say negative 10%, because that just sounds weird. So just remember, percent error is always positive. Even if it comes out negative, just switch the sign so that it becomes positive. Now let's very briefly go over significant figures. Now you need to count significant figures, and that depends on whether the decimal point is absent or present. So let's start with P, or Pacific. So in Pacific, the decimal point must be present. So P for Pacific. If the decimal point is present, you have to start counting digits from the Pacific, or left side, starting with the first non-zero digit. So let's see what this means. Let's try two examples. In example one, we see that the decimal point is present between the zero and the zero. So we need to start counting from the Pacific, or left side, and we need to start with a non-zero digit. Now, If you notice, I underlined only these six digits, and let's see why. We start counting from the Pacific side or the left side, meaning going from left to right, starting with the first non-zero digit. These three are zeros, so we can't count them. We have to start with the first non-zero digit. So we ignore these three because they're all zeros. We're looking for a non-zero digit. So we start counting from left to right at the five because five is a non-zero digit. So we go 5, 4, 1, 2, 0, 0. We count six significant figures here because we start counting at the five, which is the first non-zero digit in the number when you come from the left. Coming from left to right, these three zeros don't count, but five is a non-zero digit, so we start counting there. All right, and notice that we counted these two zeros at the end. The reason for this is because as soon as you start counting from left to right with the significant figures, you can't stop until you get to the end. All right, example two right here. We have 606.203. Notice that this is Pacific, or P, because the decimal point is present, P for present, right in between the 6 and the 2. So we start counting digits from the Pacific or left side, starting at the first non-zero digit. If we look from left to right, we get 606.203. So we started counting at the 6, and we keep going until the end. We don't stop, as I showed you in the previous example. So we go 606203. So we're counting from left to right, starting at the 6, all the way at the left side here, since it's a non-zero digit, and we count six significant figures. And let's just remember again, the zero is counted because we don't stop once we start counting the sig figs. Atlantic now is the opposite case, A for Atlantic. The reason why it's A for Atlantic is because if the decimal point is absent, or A for absent, you have to start counting digits from the Atlantic, or A, meaning the right side. The Atlantic Ocean, for example, on a map, is in the eastern United States, so it's on the right side. And you have to start counting with the first non-zero digit. So in other words, if the decimal point is absent, you start counting from the A, Atlantic, or the right side, starting with the first non-zero digit. So you basically go from right to left instead of from left to right. Atlantic, you have to start the Atlantic, the right side, and go towards the left. So if we look here, we have to go from right to left. This is the reverse of Pacific. So the decimal point is absent, so we go from right to left. We don't count these zeros because going from right to left, these are not non-zero numbers. We're looking for non-zero numbers. So going from right to left, 5 is the first non-zero number, followed by 6, 7, and a 2. So here we have four significant figures. So we start counting at the 5, which is the first non-zero digit coming from the right. We count 5, 6, 7, 2. These are four significant figures that we count coming from the right and going towards the left. All right, the next example is 500. If we notice here, when we go from right to left, we ignore these two zeros because they are zeros. We want a non-zero digit only. All right, so we start counting at the 5, and that's where we stop, because this is the last number on the left. So we have one significant figure because you start counting at the 5, which is the first non-zero digit coming from the left. And in fact, it's the only non-zero digit coming from the left. So you have one significant figure here. Now let's talk about operations and significant figures. Here I just want you to focus on what's written on the slides here. And you might want to write these little numbers down at the bottom that I've written here, just before proceeding with understanding this slide. All right, so these operations have very simple rules that you can follow. With addition and subtraction, I only want you to focus on the least number of decimal places in the original problem. All right, with multiplication and division, I only want you to focus on the least number of significant figures in the original problem. So let me show you what that means. Let's look at the number of decimal places in this problem. The example asks us to find the difference between 6.351 and 2.45, right? So we need to find out how many decimal places there are in each quantity. In 6.351, we have three decimal places. In 2.45 grams, we have two decimal places. The rule states here that we need to look at the two quantities we're using, or however many quantities we're using, and decide which one has the least number of decimal places. Out of these two, the one with the least number of decimal places is 2.45. All right, so therefore, we notice that it has two decimal places. Because this has two decimal places, this is the least number of decimal places. Therefore, 3.90 is how the answer should be written, because 3.90 has two decimal places just like 2.45 grams does. So just make sure that the decimal places here matches the least number of decimal places possible based on the original quantities. Same idea here, 2.5 milliliters plus 3.467 milliliters. We have to look at the number of decimal places. This is one decimal place. This is three decimal places. Based on these two answer choices, we could have one decimal place in the answer or three. We want to go with the lower number of decimal places, so we got to have one decimal place in the answer. That's why we wrote the answer as 6.0 milliliters, because you have one decimal place in 2.5. Here we wrote the answer as 3.90 because out of these two choices for the number of decimal places, we got to choose the lower number. So we have two decimal places in 2.45, so we should have two decimal places in 3.90. All right, now with multiplication and division, we have to find the quantity that we started with the least number of significant figures. So basically what we're doing is we have to find the number of significant figures that we're working with originally and choose whichever number has the least number of significant figures, and that's how many should be in your answer. So let me show you what that means. 3.14152, if you just use the rules from the previous slide, you'll find out that this has six significant figures. And if you look at 2 millimeters, if you just use the rules from the previous slide, you'll realize that this has one significant figure. Now, the answer choice should have either one significant figure or six. Which one do we want? Less is more in this case. So we want to focus on the one with less significant figures, 2 millimeters. All right? So therefore, we're choosing that the answer should have one significant figure, because the smaller number is the better one in terms of significant figures. 2 has one significant figure, 3.14152 has 6. We want to go with 1, all right, because we want to focus on what's important or significant. So therefore, 6 millimeters accurately reflects this answer with the proper number of sig figs, all right? One significant figure in 2, therefore the answer should also have one significant figure. We don't want 6, we want 1. That just also makes our lives easier when we're calculating. Now, with 5.43 grams divided by 6 milliliters, we're trying to find the density. 5.43 grams has three significant figures if you just use the rules from the last slide. And 6 milliliters, if you use the rules from the last slide, has one significant figure. When we're choosing how many sig figs should be in the answer, we have to choose the lower number. We have 3 here with 5.43, and we have 1 here with 6. How many should be in our answer? The lower number. So we should have one significant figure in the answer, which is written as 0.9. All right, so since there's one significant figure in 6, that's the lower number, so we should have one significant figure also in the answer. So the moral of the story here is with decimal places, just look for the quantity with the least number of decimal places. That tells you how many there should be in the answer. With multiplication and division, just look for the quantity with the least number of significant figures, and that's how many should be in your answer. All right, so let's go through these guided practice questions really quickly. All right, and you should be taking the notes for what's in red on your actual slides themselves. For number one, we just got to plug in to measured and accepted and find the percent error. So the student intended to make a concentration of 1.3 moles. That's what is accepted, or what our ideal is. That's what we wanted to do. So the accepted value is 1.3. The student's solution was analyzed and actually contained 0.67. So that is the measured value, because it was what was analyzed. So if we plug in measure minus accepted divided by accepted times 100, we get 0.67 minus 1.3 divided by 1.3 times 100, or 48.5%. It gives you negative 48.5, but again, let's just remember the percent error should be positive. Same idea here. The accepted value for the heat of vaporization of water is 2,260. That's just something that I'll tell you right now. The determined value, or the measured value, is 2,246. So if you do measured minus accepted divided by accepted times 100, you get 2,246 minus 2,260 divided by 2,260 times 100%. And if you get that, it should be 0.62% when you convert to something positive. 14.0067 here, we have to find the number of sig figs. Since the decimal point is present, we start at the first non-zero number going from the Pacific to the Atlantic, so we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 significant figures. Here we have 0.00791, the decimal point is present, and we start at the first non-zero digit, and we go from Pacific to Atlantic. So we go 791, that's 3 significant figures, expressed to 1, it's 0.008. Here we just have to follow the rules from the previous slide, and you can just do that on your own. All right. Finally, please complete the problems on this slide on your own for Thursday, September 11th. Thank you very much. Please also write down the successive value for the heat diffusion of water. Thank you.